I have to say that it's one of the most extraordinary days I ever had as a sports photographer. It was a celebration of being Irish. The stadium was absolutely packed with Irish fans. That's all there was, from what I could see. And interestingly, I don't remember anything about the match, the actual match. I remember the penalty shootout match. I can't even remember which end I was at. I don't remember any big moments. I don't remember how unlucky we were to get this or that. Just before the match and the penalty shootout.
It's now a lottery, effectively, the cruelest of methods to decide a football match.
When I think back to the penalty shootout, we ended up right where all the Bank of Irish fans were. It was quite incredible, quite incredible. A couple of months before that World Cup, and we were playing against Aberdeen in the Scottish Cup final. I think it was the first penalty shootout in the Cup final. And I wasn't probably prepared for it in many ways, and when I look back on it, but I went the right way for one penalty out of something like eight or nine penalties, which is incredible when you think about it. Even the one that went over the crossbar, I was going the wrong way. I can't imagine that was any preparation for going into a World Cup. But when I look back on it, it was a perfect preparation in many ways, because now I had to sit down and analyse the situation. And it wasn't really me that sort of went through that analytical process. It was my great friend, Gerry Payton, who was the second goalkeeper with me at the time. And he had watched the Cup final, and he had watched how I performed, and he had watched what I did. And the two of us chatted it through and chatted it through, probably not knowing also that if we went into a World Cup, that there might be a penalty shootout.
Well, the roar goes up because Pat Bonner is going to be first between the posts. Jack Charlton has done all he can. It's out of his hands now.
The Irish team, I had the feeling that they are on the penalty shootout much more strong mentally than us.
Georgi Hadji, their top player, against Pat Bonner. And that is 1-0.
I remember speaking to Kevin Sheedy and right before the thing, and he said, I think that was about 10 minutes before we even kicked off, and Kevin had said to me that he was going to hit the first penalty and he was going to hit it straight down the middle.
And Kevin Sheedy will step up to take Ireland's first penalty. Yes. If Hatchie's was decisive, Sheedy's was even more so. It's 2-1 Romania, this to stay level. Yes! Yeah. 3-2 Romania. Ah, yes! Pat Bonner from Donegal against Ionut Lupescu from Bucharest.
Behind Pecky was the fans from Ireland, the green block there, you know. You have to be a very strong character, you know, and to be mentally focused and to be very strong. You know, everybody score. Say, oof, it's not easy. What's happened if I will not score now, you know? So you have even more pressure.
Bonner, furious with himself. Again, he guessed correctly.
Paki, you went to my ball, but I scored quite high, so it was impossible.
Feel it just touching my fingers. I'm kind of, that was a moment. Do I get a second chance at it?
Oh, yes. We can breathe again. This most dramatic finale in Irish soccer history continues.
We had discussed about what do you do in the situation in relation to somebody coming up to take a penalty, the position that he take, and how then they were going to execute. Gerry had come up with a sort of kind of methodology that if he stood direct, straight on, he was going to either blast the ball or side foot the ball. But if he stood at an acute angle, he was going to put the ball almost back into where the same side as he was standing on, if that makes sense. It gave me a focus point. It gave me something to really think about during the process.
I'm actually not thinking of the enormity of the situation, like that if Tomofi gets the penalty, then it's going to change. Whatever, that's not in my mind. I'm just absolutely concentrating on getting the photograph. It's much more a professional photographic focus than, God, if he saves this, you know, I'm going to make millions or something, you know what I mean? Like, it's not like that.
It's not easy, you know, when you move from the 16 box to the 11, so in 10 meters, you see the goal like this, and every meter, it's slower down, and smaller, smaller, and smaller, and the ball is from this size getting smaller, smaller, smaller. So, you know, it's not easy.
Timopte against Bonner.
When you look at Daniel Tomofti's penalty, when he stood at an almost acute, exactly what we talked about, an acute angle. He put the penalty the same side as he was standing.
The big man from Donegal has set it up for a victory.
The shot I was looking for was that one where he's going like that.
This is the moment that he'll treasure for the rest of his days, I'm sure.
You have a feeling and you want it to happen, and when it happens, I have to say, I suppose when he actually saved it, it's in there, I've actually got it. Seminal moment, obviously, for him, but actually a really seminal moment for me as a sports photographer. So very important. And then you just move on to the next thing, when David Leary stepped up.
David Leary never had a penalty in his life.
This kick can decide it all. The nation holds its breath. Yes, we're there! Ireland are through to the quarterfinals of the World Cup.
The reaction of the staff, my word, I always remember that. The run from all the staff to jump on top of Dave. And we had little Charlie O'Leary, our little kit man, and he was only about 5 foot tall. And when he ran out, he was trying to jump up in that group, but he couldn't get up there. He was just jumping.
I just remember at the 1992 World Cup, I was actually on fire. Some of the best pictures I ever took, I had Paul Gascoigne crying, I had the Cameroons jumping on top of each other in a goal against England. I've got about five or six pictures there that I would quite happily show anybody anytime. And Paddy Bonner's save was a really much very important part of that.
Daniel Tomofti is a name in Ireland that people, if you spoke to now a generation of people, they would know him right away. And I had the opportunity to talk to him years later, but what he told me was that they had a bar that was called The Penalty. And what he said to me was, the reason why I had called it and I opened a pub was that if anybody gave me stick, I could chuck them out.
There has never been an achievement in Irish sport to parallel this.